Prince there, surging forward 5 to 12 with Thieves in the Temple. And you know, he's a bit of a legend in Australia, Prince. Because of his small stature, he can find a tube in Narrabeen where most people can't. We'll be back with the top 11.
Mystic places.
Music,
television,
vicious,
slim,
tea,
live,
mice,
sit,
on,
cuisine,
most
wild,
seismic,
olive,
love,
movie,
slice,
unit,
muscle,
vision,
tie.
I'm Andrew Datto, and I don't want to state the obvious, but I'm sure you all know that Ricky Bell, Michael Bivins and Ronnie DeVoe are former members of New Edition. And of course, the good news is there's the big New Edition reunion coming up at this year's Video Music Awards. The question is, how will their success affect the chances of more New Edition activity in the future? Well, here's what Ricky Bell had to say about that.
If anything, we're going to expand that New Edition audience, if anything, because once we come back together as New Edition, And you know, once it's Ralph and then Johnny and Bobby and then all of us together, that's just like something that everybody wants to see. And some people don't want to see that, you know, but it's going to happen. I think, if anything, it's just going to expand that New Edition audience.
And I'm sure you'd agree there's a huge New Edition audience already. Doomy shoots ahead 7 to 11 for Bell, Biv, DeVoe, and that makes them a jet screamer. Bell, Biv, DeVoe, scream ahead 7 to 11 with Doomy. And that concludes the first half of our work. Let's recheck our answers and then move on. Slaughter debuts at 20 this week with Fly to the Angels. At 19, Snap plunges 8 floors with The Power. Another debut at 18, Depeche Mode and Policy of Truth. Maxi Priest jumps 3 with Close to You in at 17. Dino debuts at 16 with Romeo. And at 15, Phil Collins also debuts with Something Happened on the Way to Heaven. Cheap Trick keeps moving ahead up 2 to 14 this week with Can't Stop Falling in Love. Janet Jackson slips to 13 with Come Back Me. Prince leaps 5 to 12 with Thieves in the Temple. And Bell, Biv, DeVoe leaps 7 to 11 with Doomy. It's been 16 weeks on the countdown for Billy Idol and Cradle of Love. That's 1 week short of the record set by Dire Straits. And can he hang on to set the record? Well, only time will tell. Fortunately, unfortunately, even Cradle of Love falls 3 to 10 for Billy Idol. You know, one of the very first things I did here when I arrived was a couple of Saturday mornings New Kids specials, so I feel uniquely qualified for this next segment. See, I subscribe to all the New Kids magazines, like 16, you know, when they've got stuff, I always get it. And I can even tell you that Joe has, right, an above grade average. Isn't that fantastic? It certainly is. Well, they're up 5-9 with tonight, New Kids on the Block. Gee whiz, one of my favourite bands in the whole world. No, they are, really. No, really, they are. New Kids on the Block.
How you doing?
How you doing?
Is this the right place?
Yeah, it's...
New Kids on the Block bounce up 5-9 with tonight. Now, be honest with me. Do you miss him? I knew it. Ah, we'll be right back. Think about me.
Thursday night, September 6th, worldwide, the 1990 MTV Video Music Awards, starring Arsenio Hall. The top videos, the top performers of the year, all live. Performances by Aerosmith, Phil Collins, Faith No More, MC Hammer, INXS, Janet Jackson, Madonna, Motley Crue. A New Edition reunion with Bobby Brown, Belle Biv DeVoe, and Johnny Gill. Sinead O'Connor, World Party, and more. With Cher, Flavor Flav, Don Henley, Billy Idol, Living Color, Wilson Phillips, and more. Stop. The 1990 MTV Video Music Awards, beaming out across the planet to MTV Europe, Japan, Greece, South America, Israel, Australia, China, and beyond. Watch it along with the rest of the world, Thursday, September 6th at 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific, live on MTV and nowhere else.
When I'm trying to talk to people, I'll choose a format that people naturally look at, be it an electronic sign or a television, and in these media, I'll put a sentence that's hopefully about the hard topics that'll tell people how to live well and mercifully. MTV influences me because I'm always trying to figure out how to deal with hard subjects on television and not put people to sleep. And MTV does these things pretty well.
Andrew Datto here, filling in for Adam Curry while he's taking just a short vacation. Now, there have been a number of videos off Aerosmith's Pump LP, and they all have a few things in common, of course. There's Joe Perry's guitar and Steven Tyler's unique vocals, and they all feature that old guy with the beard. Now, that old guy with the beard, in case you're wondering, is a bloke called John Kolodner, and he's actually just a very close friend of the band. He's in this one as well. Here's The Other Side, Down 3-8 for Aerosmith. Aerosmith, Slip Away 3-8 with The Other Side. You know about Nelson, right? Now, you know that Love and Affection was written for Cindy Crawford, supermodel Cindy Crawford. I'm proud to say MTV's very own Cindy Crawford. Well, if you weren't aware of that, that's who the song is written about. And here's what Nelson, Gunnar and Maddie, had to say about it.
I like the way it turned out, too, because it can apply to everybody who has fantasized about being with someone that's unattainable at the time, or you would think would be unattainable.
Right.
And I don't know, just being frustrated. It was a song born out of frustration.
No frustration here. I know I can't have it. This is Nelson with Love and Affection.
Done. Can we do this?
Yeah, check her out.
Okay.
Love and Affection pounces onto number 7, up 3 for Nelson. Now, if you're having trouble remembering which is which, as I do, a good trick is Matthew has the bangs, the fringe, right? And the second letter in both Matthew and bangs is A, okay? So Matthew bangs. But, of course, the third letter in both Gunner and bangs is N. So you don't want to think about it too much.
I always thought E meant empty.
Have faith, compadres.
Yeah, they're so big on chocolate after here. It's hard to keep them on the rocks.
Now we're stuck. I don't know, that depends on how you look at it.
Those three musketeers.
Never run out of gas when I drive.
And Andrew Datto filling in for Adam Curry, and right now MC Hammer. He's nominated for a couple of Video Music Awards, he's on the cover of Rolling Stone magazine, he's probably going to start working for NASA, and things actually couldn't be going much better for him, except for here on The Countdown, where he falls 3-6 with Have You Seen Her?
She'll be fly in the last. I see her face and I can't let go. She's in my dreams and my heart, so let me know. Could she be?
MC Hammer down 3-6. Although Epic may be the first that you've heard from the band Faith No More, they've actually been around for years. In fact, they've got two previous albums. There are a few things that differentiate their music from before to their current release, and lead singer Mike Patton is one of those. He's been with the band for about a year. When Rolling Stone asked bassist Billy Gould about their new record, he told them, "We had a little more money and time in the studio, and Mike can sing. He kind of elevates everything." Faith No More elevates themselves up 1-5 this week with Epic. Epic thrashes up 1-5 for Faith No More. A couple of options. You could leave now or you could stay put. I think you should stay put.
Music.
Television.
Vicious.
Slim T.
Live.
Mice.
Sit.
On.
Us.
Cuisine.
Most Wild.
Seismic.
Olive.
Love.
Movie.
Slice.
Unit.
Muscle.
Vision.
Tie.
Andrew Datto here filling in for Adam Curry, and I have a letter here from Darlene Frederick from Charleston in West Virginia, and evidently Darlene heard Adam talking about all the Wilson sisters on The Countdown, Anson and Nancy of Heart and Wendy and Carney of Wilson Phillips, and thought they were all one big happy family, just a big bunch of sisters, kind of like the Brady Bunch but one extra, right? And she thought that was incredibly cool. Well, listen Darlene, I hate to burst your bubble, but Wendy and Carney are no relation to Ann and Nancy, or for that matter to Cindy Wilson of the B-52s. They could somehow be related to Mr. Wilson from the old Dennis the Menace show. I don't know, I could be lying. Thanks for writing anyway, Darlene. I'll have someone send you an MTV t-shirt. And now, here's Wendy and Carney with their mate China. That's right, it's Wilson Phillips with Release Me, up 4-4.